My family, now Carnival of so-called expert Richard Palmer has reacted to Prince Harry and Meghan's interview with CBS's Jane Pauley, whereby Harry and Meghan have launched the Parents Network to address the dangers of online harm and protect children and also parents. And my family, before I speak of the reaction of Carnival of so-called expert Richard Palmer, allow me to show you a clip of what Meghan said during the interview. My family, kindly please look at this, please.
Comfort and power in numbers, with the goal, as Harry himself once said, of turning pain
Into
into
purpose.
purpose. And the two of you, this is it's a modest beginning. It's not an army of parents yet. But what are your ambitions?
I think you have to start somewhere. I think the simplest thing that anyone watching this, or anyone who's able to make change, to look at it through the lens of, what if it was my daughter? What if it was my son? My son or my daughter who comes home, who are joyful, who I love, and one day, right under my roof, our entire lives change because of something that was completely out of our control. And if you look at it through the lens as a parent, there is no way to see that any other way than to try to find a solution.
A solution. My family, Meghan and Harry are doing what they can to protect children from online harm. And my family, Harry and Meghan are doing something very, very good, something very, very amazing. Very, very amazing. Harry and Meghan have suffered from online bullying and online trolling. And Harry and Meghan, despite what they have experienced and endured, they choose to do good. They don't want anyone else to go through what they have gone through. That's who Harry and Meghan are. Amazing, remarkable human beings. And my family, good always wins. Love always triumphs over evil. And that's a fact. Now, my family, apparently, of course, UK media, Carnival of so-called experts have watched Prince Harry and Meghan's interview. And I want to read you the reaction from Carnival of so-called expert Richard Palmer, who my family lost his job at the Daily Express. And now my family basically somehow works for himself right now. And clearly, he hasn't stopped trying to use Harry and Meghan's names to make money for himself. Now, Richard Palmer posted a comment on X, formerly called Twitter, saying this, and I quote, "It is an important issue what Harry and Meghan are working on. And one that they, Harry and Meghan, and the Prince and Princess of Wales, William and Kate, have been highlighting for some years." Let me continue. "Some might think that they, and we in the media, also have a responsibility to rein it in, to reduce toxicity online for adults too," said Richard Palmer. Now, my family, what makes me laugh is that time and time again, we are seeing Carnival of so-called experts attaching the names of Prince William and Kate Middleton onto Harry and Meghan's projects, onto causes that Harry and Meghan are deeply, deeply involved in. Right now, William and Kate are enjoying their vacation. Right now, they are on vacation. I mean, my family, they're always on vacation. But right now, it's more official that they're really on vacation. And while they are on vacation, Harry and Meghan are doing something remarkable. Harry and Meghan are fighting online bullying. Harry and Meghan are fighting to protect kids from online harm. They want to create a safe environment, atmosphere for children, whereby no parent has to suffer the pain of losing their child because of online harm, because of online bullying, for example. No parent should ever have to go through that. You know? And also, as I've been saying, social media companies need to do a lot in tackling online bullying. They must do something about what is going on online. You know? My family, online bullying must never, ever be condoned. It must always be condemned. Now, my family, basically, time and time again, we are seeing that UK media are showing the entire world that William and Kay Middleton don't have anything substantial that they have achieved on their own, to the point that UK media are desperate to attach William and Kate's names onto Harry and Meghan's work. For example, look even at the Invictus Games. Look at that. UK media have been calling William the co-founder of the Invictus Games, which is not true. Which is not true. In fact, in Harry's memoir Spare, Harry tells us very well that William was very, very discouraging of Prince Harry pushing ahead with his plans to create the Invictus Games, support wounded, sick, injured servicemen and women. Harry tells us in Spare, William was very, very discouraging, you know, to Prince Harry. And if Harry had listened to William's words, if William's words discouraged Prince Harry, I can tell you there would be no Invictus Games. And my family, we know of the impact of the Invictus Games. It has touched the lives of so many people, of so many veterans and their families. Harry tells us in The Heart of Invictus documentary on Netflix that he has lost count of the children, moms, dads, servicemen and women who've come up to him to thank him for creating, for founding the Invictus Games. And because of the enormous success of the Invictus Games, we have seen UK media trying to attach William's name and Kate's name onto the success of the Invictus Games. They have tried to attach William and Kate's name onto the success of the Invictus Games. And my family, whenever they do that, what they're doing is that they're showing that William has achieved nothing of substance on his own. Nothing. William has this so-called art flow prize. Why can't UK media promote that? Why can't they say that this is what William has achieved? My family, the reason why they don't even mention what William is doing with the Art Flow Prize is because they know that my family William is someone who is full of hypocrisy, my family. William is someone who is full of hypocrisy. For example, he is someone who lectures everyone that he wants to save the climate, yet he's flying on private jets. Number two, the reason why UK media don't even mention Earthflop as an achievement is because my family, they know that it doesn't come close to what Harry is doing with the Invictus Games. They know it. They all know it. They all know that very well. And clearly, from what UK media are showing, they are not just going to try and attach William's name onto the success of the Invictus Games. They are going to attach William and Kate's names onto projects that Harry and Meghan are deeply passionate about, even right now. Like what Harry and Meghan are doing, fighting online bullying, finding ways to protect children, from online bullying. Finding ways to keep kids safe, to create an online environment whereby it is safe and conducive for children. That's what Harry and Meghan are trying to do. That's what Harry and Meghan are trying to do, and that's what they are extremely passionate about. And my family, right now, I am seeing a carnival of so-called expert who lost his job at the Daily Express, a tabloid that regularly incites hatred against Harry and Meghan. The Daily Express, someone who worked there and lost his job, my family, after working there for many, many years, he's trying to attach William and Kate's names onto my family, what Harry and Meghan right now are doing. Whereby Harry and Meghan are fighting online bullying, my family. And the thing is, I have to call out the hypocrisy of the British media because they are so full of hypocrisy. And once again, you are being shown that clearly William has not achieved anything substantial. And no wonder he is so jealous of Prince Harry's achievements. He is so jealous of Harry's success. In the words of Carnival of so-called expert Robert Jobson, who is Prince William's cheerleader, he said that Prince William did not believe that after Prince Harry stepped back as a senior member of the royal family, he did not think that the Invictus Games would continue to succeed. He thought it would fail. He thought that Prince Harry would fail to get people to financially back the Invictus Games. But instead, we are seeing that my family, everything is going well. And no wonder Robert Jobson said that Prince William is extremely jealous of Harry's success with the Invictus Games. No wonder. No wonder Carnival of so-called expert Robert Jobson said that, my family. And the thing is, it is so despicable that William sought to destroy the Invictus Games all because of jealousy. Or because he's so jealous of what Harry has built, of the success of the spare. He is so jealous and full of envy towards that. And I find it so hypocritical that a carnival of so-called expert is trying to attach the names of William and Kate Middleton, who are two of the biggest bullies who are bullied. Not only Harry and Meghan, but also their kids. That he, Palmer Richard, is trying to attach the names of William and Kim Houghton, whereby he's claiming that they also are fighting online bullying. William and Kim Houghton, seriously. William and Kim Houghton, seriously. You know, let me read you what William did to Meghan from Harry's memoir spear. Even when Meghan was pregnant with Harry's first child. You know, let me read you this. You know, and my family, today Meghan, in the video released by CBS, Meghan has revealed that she has not really scraped the surface with her own experiences of what she endured in the royal family. There are things that Meghan has not said. There are things that Meghan has not told us about what she experienced in the royal family. Because, and that's why I'm asking, Meghan, what really did they do to you that you have not told us? There must have been something more that really happened to Meghan that Meghan has not shared with us. You know? And my family, no wonder Tyler Perry said, there are many things that Meghan could have said. Clearly, there are many things that Meghan could have said. But clearly, you know, she did not. She held back. She really, really held back. And my family, basically, when I read Spare, you know, and Harry tells us some things that happened to Meghan, my family, how can anybody ever claim or even say that William and Kim Houghton are the ones who are, you know, also part of the fight to tackle online bullying? How can anyone, after reading Spare, claim that William and Kim Houghton are part of the fight to tackle online bullying? William and Kim Houghton are the biggest bullies in the royal family. You know, let me read you this to back up my words. Let me read you Harry's memoir Spare. Because my family, we always have proof. Always. You know? We always have proof. You know? And my family, the thing is, you know, here's what Harry wrote in his memoir Spare. You know? And I quote, "I was glad that Willie felt he could still come to me about Pa and Camilla, even after all we had been through recently. Seeing an opportunity to address our own recent tensions, I tried to connect what Pa and Camilla had done to him with what the press had done to Meghan, whereby Pa and Camilla had briefed against Prince William, and William did not like it." And Harry, of course, tried to connect what Pa and Camilla had done to William with what the press had done to Meghan. And then when Harry did that, William snapped. He snapped and got angry and told Harry, and I quote, "I've got different issues with you two, with you and Meghan." In a blink, he shifted all his rage onto me, Harry says of Prince William's temper, his rage. You know? Clearly, William has a huge, huge temper. A very, very big temper. And no wonder you can media always describe William as being incandescent with rage. My family, Harry is repeating it in Spare, that William clearly is someone who has a huge temper. Harry then says, and I quote, "In a blink, William shifted all his rage onto me." Now, my family, let me just clearly pause there for a second and say this. How can someone with such a temper, how can any carnival of so-called expert try to claim that William is tackling online bullying. Surely, surely, surely. You know, my family, let me continue with this, please. Harry says, and I quote, "I can't recall William's exact words." Harry, I believe you can. I believe you can. You are holding back. You are holding back. You are holding back. You are holding back. "I can't recall his exact words," says Harry, "because I was beyond tired from all our fighting. To say nothing of the recent move into Frogmore and into new offices, and I was focused on the imminent birth of our first child. But I recall every physical detail of the scene. The daffodils out. The new grass sprouting. A jet taking off from Heathrow, heading west, unusually low, its engines making my chest vibrate. I remember thinking how remarkable that I could still hear Willie above that jet." What Harry is saying here is that William, he was raising his voice so high that my family, while he was shouting at Prince Harry, Harry could hear the voice of Prince William, his shouts, his screams, more than he had my family, the engine, you know, noise from a jet. Harry then says, and I quote, "I could not imagine how he had that much anger left after the confrontation in Notcourt. He was going on, and I lost the thread. I couldn't understand, and I stopped trying. I fell silent, waiting for him to subside. Then I looked back. Meghan was coming from the house directly towards me. I quickly took the phone off speaker, but she'd already heard. And Willie was being so loud, even with the speaker off, she, Meghan, could still hear. The tears in her eyes glistened in the spring sunshine." I'm assuming that the reason why Meghan was crying was because William was throwing insults towards her in a phone call to Prince Harry. My family, William is a bully. He's a bully. He is one of the bullies who bullied Meghan and even made Meghan cry. For a carnival of so-called expert, who's a cheerleader of Prince William and Kate Middleton, as Richard Palmer is, as most of the carnival of so-called experts are, because they made a deal with William and Kate Middleton to give them good press, to promote them, to prop them up while undermining Harry and Meghan. My family, in as much as this carnival of so-called experts are William's cheerleaders, my family, how can you claim that William is one of the people who are fighting against online bullying when he is the biggest bully ever? It is like saying that the Daily Mail condemns bullying. Have you ever seen Daily Mail ever condemning bullying? Really? It's like saying the Daily Mail is a tabloid that spreads love. Have you ever seen Daily Mail spreading love in the UK, my family? Its business model depends or relies on members of the royal family being at odds with each other. And Daily Mail is one tabloid that is so hateful towards others. And my family, I condemn, you know, their actions. Daily Mail is also one of the tabloids that were clearly racist towards Meghan. So my family, when I see someone trying to, you know, champion William as a campaigner against online bullying, I have to call out their hypocrisy. I have to expose their lies. William is a bully. He's a bully who bullied Meghan even when Meghan was pregnant with Harry's first child. When William and Kate gave birth to their first child, I remember Prince Harry asking the press to back off and let William and Kate have their alone time as a family. I remember the support that Harry gave Prince William. But then William could not reciprocate the support that Harry gave him. That's the kind of person William is, because he was jealous of Harry and Meghan's power. He was jealous the public was also, you know, in love with Harry and Meghan, of how they were also affectionate towards Harry and Meghan. William could not stand it. And clearly, he wanted Meghan gone. He wanted things to return how my family, you know, it was for Meghan. Whereby Harry was the third wheel following him and Kate around. You know, whereby Harry would do the work and then William and Kate swoop in and take all the credit. William wanted things to go back to that. Most importantly, he wanted Harry to just continue being his scapegoat. You know, whereby William does something wrong and Harry takes all the blame for it. That's what William wanted. He wanted scapegoats. Wanted the scapegoat, you know, back to him. And my family also remember an interview that William did with the BBC, whereby he claimed to have psychological power over Prince Harry. Now, my family, when you see things like that, you begin to understand what William felt when he saw that he could no longer control Prince Harry or command Harry to do things. Or even remember when he tried to turn Harry against Meghan, who was carrying Harry's child also at the time. William, when he failed to turn Harry against Meghan, what did he do? How did William respond? He responded by being abusive towards Harry. He responded by physically assaulting his brother. In any normal circumstances, William would be in prison for what he did to Prince Harry, but he walks and roams free, all because he's the heir to the throne. You know, all because he's the heir to the throne. So my family, how can Palmer Richard call a bully, you know, like Prince William, someone who campaigns against online bullying? How can you claim that William, who's a bully, campaigns against online bullying? Surely, how? How? You know? My family, let me continue, please. You know? Then I looked back. Meghan was coming from the house towards me. I quickly took the phone off speaker, but she had already heard. And Willie was being so loud, even with the speaker off, she could still hear. The tears in her eyes glistened in the spring sunshine. I started to say something, but she stopped, shook her head. Holding her stomach, she turned and walked back to the house. William must have said something abusive towards Meghan. He must have abused her. And Meghan heard of William's abuse. And my family, right now, we now know it is not just William who abused and bullied Meghan. We also know that Charles also abused Meghan in a phone call to Prince Harry. And then they wonder, why would Meghan come over to the UK? Why would Meghan come over to Britain? Why? Just why? Now, my family, I've always been of the firm opinion that Prince Harry cannot have it both ways. When I say it, I mean that Prince Harry cannot, you know, somehow be able to reconcile with his family in the UK, his extended family in the UK, that's William, Charles, Kate, Camilla, and still have his family intact. You know? That's what I've always been saying. Because the royal family are sending this message whereby for as long as Harry is happy, in a happy marriage, still married to Meghan, there's no way they'll ever be able to reconcile with Prince Harry. That's the message that has been sent and continues to be sent by senior members of the royal family, whereby they want to destroy Prince Harry's family, whereby they want to destroy Harry and Meghan's marriage, to ruin Archie and Lilibet's lives. Because Archie and Lilibet Dana have a right to have both parents living under the same roof. But what do Wikimedia want? They want to destroy Harry and Meghan's union. That's what the fam also wants. That's what Charles also wants. It's what William wants. And my family, you know, the people who are hell-bent on destroying Harry and Meghan's lives, they are trying to call themselves campaigners against online bullying. Surely, surely, you know, surely, surely. You know, I've always said Prince Harry must never ever allow the family or the farm that he comes from destroy the family that comes from him. And the family that comes from Harry is Meghan, Archie, and Lilibet Dana. He must never allow William or Charles or Camilla or Kate or any Karen or anybody else to destroy his family. Because the moment, if, God forbid, he loses his own family, Harry has lost everything. He's lost everything. And that's how the firm, William and Charles, want to destroy the spare. They don't want Harry back in the UK because they love him or they care about him. No. They want him back because they can't stand seeing him shining outside of the institution. They can't stand seeing Colombia, Nigeria inviting Harry and Meghan. And nobody's calling William and Kimbleson to come over to their country for a visit. That's what they can't stand. You know? And that's why they really want that control over Prince Harry. You know, they want that back so badly. And my family, I do hope that the firm never ever succeed in, you know, getting Harry back. Harry must, you know, keep on protecting his own family and never allow anybody to ruin his own family. My family already, as I've said, William has bullied and abused Meghan. Charles has bullied and abused Meghan. Kay Moulton made Meghan cry. Camilla also is someone who is extremely dangerous. She wines and dines with people who abuse Meghan. People like Jeremy Clarkson, you know, and Piers Morgan. My family, how do you reconcile with people who've caused you so much pain as what they have caused Meghan, as what William, Charles, Kate, Camilla have caused Meghan? How? How? And that's why I keep saying this. You know, my family, even if Prince Harry wants to be able to reconcile with this, with William, with Charles, my family and the others, even if that's what Harry wants, you know, the royal family are never ever going to stand seeing Prince Harry happy. They're never ever going to stand seeing Prince Harry, you know, his kids, Archie, Lilibet Dana, being raised in a healthy, positive environment, full of love. The fam don't want that. They don't want that for Archie, for Lilibet Dana, or even for Prince Harry. And Prince Harry must protect his own family, you know, from bullies like Prince William, Charles, Kate, Camilla, and the British tabloid media. So, Palmer Richard, William is someone who has not been highlighting this. He's someone who, even when he speaks about any issue, he's someone who is not very, he's not profoundly genuine. William is not genuine. You know, my family, William is not genuine. Even someone said that, so you are attaching your lazy royals to something that Harry and Meghan created, you know, basically more than 2 years ago after they left. You people have no shame. You really can't even comprehend giving these two their own credit without insulting William and Kate's names. What are you afraid of? To be cut off the role, you know, access? Someone told that to Richard Palmer. Someone else said, shut up, Richard. William and Kate, don't do anything except ride on the coattails of Harry and Meghan. Harry and Meghan have been quiet for almost 2 years now, but Willie and Kate have not stopped briefing against Harry and Meghan. You know? William and Kate highlight how many vacations they need and how they are so keen to do more without actually doing more. William and Kate do not occupy the same intellectual space and never will. Harry and Meghan are leaps and bounds ahead of them. You know? My family. Indeed, very, very true. Indeed, very, very true. Indeed, very, very true. And don't forget that William has never ever condemned the online bullying of Meghan. When Archie was racially abused at such a young age, even William never ever condemned racism towards Archie. Please let's not forget that. Please let's not forget that at all. You know? And also on top of that, William is someone who bullied Meghan when she was pregnant. He didn't care about Harry's unborn child. He didn't care at all. None of the firm did care about Meghan being pregnant. They didn't care at all. UK media also did not care that Meghan was pregnant. They didn't care. So my family, you know, William and Kim Milton are people who are bullies. They don't campaign against online bullying. They are bullies. That's who they are. And even if they've said something maybe in the past, condemning online bullying, my family, we all know they don't mean it. Why? Because they have never ever condemned the bullying of Meghan that we have been seeing happening for all these years now. Not once have senior members of the royal family asked or called for UK media to back off of Meghan. Not even once. My family, so right now I want to hear your opinion on what we have just discussed. Do you wonder why William and Kate will always be jealous of Harry and Meghan? Don't wonder. William and Kim Milton will always be jealous of Harry and Meghan because even the carnival of so-called experts who are supposed or meant to be William and Kate's cheerleaders, my family, they can't praise William and Kim Milton without somehow trying to undermine Harry and Meghan. They know William and Kim Milton don't have any substantial achievements of their own. They know that. And that's why they try to attach them onto Harry and Meghan's work, onto Harry and Meghan's projects. You know? And my family, we are going to keep on calling out UK media whenever we see them trying to do this. Harry is the one and only founder of the Invictus Games. William and Kate did not do anything to help Harry as he was building the Invictus Games. Harry and Meghan are the ones who are fighting, you know, online bullying, fighting to keep kids safe from online harm. William and Kim Milton, they bullied Meghan when she was pregnant. My family. So those two have not campaigned genuinely, you know, they haven't genuinely campaigned to condemn online trolling or bullying of kids. William and Kate have not done that. And shame on them. Shame on them. And also, charity starts at home. Charity starts at home, my family. If William and Kim Milton cannot condemn the bullying of Meghan, how can they ever claim to be campaigners against online bullying? How? If they have never ever condemned the bullying of Meghan or Prince Harry or Archie or Lilibet, how can they ever claim, how can their cheerleaders claim that William and Kimmelton are also campaigners of against online bullying. How? My family, I want to hear your opinion on that, my family. May God bless Harry, Meghan, Archie, and also Lilibet, Dana, and Doria Ragland. And I'm so thankful to Prince Harry and Meghan for what they do to make this world a better place. And may God keep on blessing them so, so much. And may no weapon formed against Harry, Meghan, Archie, and also Lilibet, Diana ever prosper. He never wins. Love wins. And stay tuned to our next video, my family. And may no weapon formed against Harry, Meghan, Archie, and also Lilibet, Diana ever prosper, my family. Stay tuned to the next video. Love you always and forever. And may God bless you, my family. And UK media need to stop trying to attach William and Kate's names onto Harry and Meghan's, you know, successful projects, onto Harry and Meghan's achievements. They must stop doing what they're doing. Stop trying to attach William and Kate's names onto Harry and Meghan's achievements. Stop it. Tell William and Kimmelton, stop being lazy. Go out there and work and find something to do of substance that will actually make an impact. And tell them to stop briefing negative stories about Harry and Meghan. Stop lying about Harry and Meghan and leave Harry and Meghan alone. Let them live in peace. We all know all the anti-Harry and Meghan stories come from William and Kate's office. They need to leave Harry and Meghan alone, my family. Once again, we condemn bullying in all its forms. We demand that senior members of the royal family, William, Charles, Kate, Camilla, and also UK media and Trolls Online, stop the bullying of Harry and Meghan. Leave Harry and Meghan alone. Let them live in peace. My family, stay tuned to this video. Love you, always and forever. Hello, members of Zesco Family TV. First of all, I want to say thank you for all your support that you give us to our channel. We don't take it for granted that you support this channel. I want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts for lending out your support and fighting against injustices, supporting Prince Harry and Meghan, showing them love. Love will always triumph over evil, and for that I say thank you. Good will always prevail over bad. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you so much for joining this community, this amazing community of Zesco Family TV. I love you so much, family, from the bottom of my heart. And I wish you all the best. May you have a great, great day. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and learned a lot of things. With that and so much more, stay tuned to our next video. Leave a comment below, like, and subscribe. Love you, family, always and forever. Sayonara.